हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू ईसी अकाडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड स्पेक्ट्रम एंड बैंडविड्थ ऑफ बी एफ एस के सिग्नल। फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द स्पेक्ट्रम ऑफ बी एफ एस के सिग्नल। वी कैन राइट बी एफ एस के सिग्नल एज एस ऑफ टी इज इक्वल टू स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 2ps इंटू पी एच ऑफ टी कॉस 2π एफ एच टी प्लस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 2ps pl ऑफ टी कॉस 2π एफ एल टी। लेट अस टेक दिस एज इक्वेशन नंबर 1। सो इन दिस इक्वेशन इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग एफ नॉट प्लस ओमेगा वी हैव रिटन इट एज एफ एच एंड इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग एफ नॉट माइनस ओमेगा वी हैव रिटन इट एज एफ एल। वी नो द bps के सिग्नल कैन बी रिटन एज b ऑफ टी स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 2p कॉस 2π एफ नॉट टी। Let us take this as equation number 2. If we compare equation 1 and equation 2, we observe that both the equations are same. So in BPSK, we are using B of T and in BFSK, we are using PH of T and PL of T. Here B of T is bipolar and PH of T and PL of T are unipolar. Now let us convert this unipolar value into bipolar value. So for that we'll write pH of t is equal to 1/2 plus 1/2 pH dash of t and PL of t is equal to 1/2 plus 1/2 into PL dash of t. So here pH dash of t and PL dash of t both are bipolar, which means it can have the value plus 1 or minus 1. So half of bipolar value plus half will give the unipolar value. So using that analysis, we have written the value of pH of T and PL of T in bipolar. Now let us substitute these two values in equation number 1. We'll get S of T is equal to square root of 2ps into 1/2 plus 1/2 pH dash of T into cos 2π fht plus square root of 2ps into 1/2 plus 1/2 pl dash of t cos 2π flt. So what we have done, instead of pH of t and pl of t in this equation, we have written it as 1/2 plus 1/2 pH dash of t and 1/2 plus 1/2 pl dash of t. If we simplify this, we will get S of t is equal to square root of ps by 2 cos 2π fht plus square root of ps by 2 cos 2π flt plus square root of ps by 2 ph dash of t cos 2π fht plus square root of ps by 2 pl dash of t cos 2π flt. In this equation, the first term represents single frequency impulse function at frequency fh, and the second term represents single frequency impulse function at frequency fl. The third and fourth term in this equation represents BPSK equation. Using this analysis, we can write the power spectral density of BFSK signal as f of s is equal to, in this equation we can take root ps by 2 as common, and the first term is the impulse function centered at the frequency fh. Second term is impulse function which is centered across the frequency fl, and third and fourth term is taken from the power spectral density of BPSK signal. So let us represent these two impulse response first. So we'll write frequency fl and we'll write the frequency fh. There we'll write the impulse function that represents these two impulse function, and along with that this signum function is centered at the frequency fh. So we'll write one signum function which is centered across frequency fh, and this signum function is centered across the frequency fl. So we'll write one more signum function which is centered across frequency fl. The distance between fl and fh will be equal to 2fb. This is the plot of power spectral density of BFSK signal. To find the bandwidth, if you can observe here, from this point to this point it is fb, from here to here it is fb. So half of this signum function is fb, other half will also be equal to fb. So from this point to this point it will be fb, Again, from this point to this point, it will be FB. So FB plus FB plus FB plus FB. So it will be 4FB. So bandwidth of BFSK signal will be equal to 4FB. This is about spectrum and bandwidth of BFSK signal. Hope you have understood the topic. Thank you.